YouTube, what's good? Welcome back to another video, guys. Today I'm playing some Call of Duty Ghost on the Xbox Series X in 2021. This game released on November 5th of 2013, nearly making it 8 years old now. This game originally released on the PlayStation 3 and the Xbox 360, but shortly after the Xbox One and the PS4 came out, so this was the first Call of Duty on the next-gen consoles at the time. That's something that's definitely crazy to think about nowadays, since we just had the Xbox Series X and the PlayStation 5 come out, and we saw the same pattern with Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. It originally released on the Xbox One and the PS4, and now it transferred over to the Xbox Series X and the PS5. This game on the Xbox Series X has a boosted FPS, an auto HDR support, and an improved resolution, which all make the game look absolutely fantastic. This also helps with the gameplay, which is significantly smoother and plays a lot better. Call of Duty Ghost had a lot of mixed opinions about it overall, but for me personally, I definitely enjoyed the game a fair amount. So I was definitely excited to get back on this game after so many years and play some multiplayer. And to my surprise, I found a game fairly quickly. It wasn't Team Deathmatch because that's where the most players were playing, but overall, I was able to get into games consistently, and this was something that definitely surprised me since this game is so old now. In the main lobby, it tells you how many players are on, roughly. I don't know how accurate that was because it was definitely a low number and I was able to find games pretty consistently. With that being said though, I was definitely not complaining that I was able to find lobbies with no problems at all. If you guys have been playing, let me know down in the comments below if you guys have been able to find games with no problems at all. Something to note is the fact that I was playing around midday, so that may have been when a bunch of players were on compared to other times in the day. Something I always recommend is not playing too early in the morning or too late at night in these older Call of Duties to find games. I've been playing a lot of older Call of Duties recently, and something I've definitely picked up on is the fact that people play in the midday and definitely not too early in the morning or late at night. So keep that in mind if you plan to play one of these older Call of Duties, because it can definitely help you out in finding some lobbies. Now, the multiplayer in Call of Duty Ghost was definitely something that we hadn't seen before, especially when it came to the maps. And what I mean by that is the fact that the maps were definitely very interactive. So for example, there was a specific map where if you wanted to get on top of a building, you needed to shoot down a ladder in order to get up there. I know it doesn't sound like anything crazy for those of you that don't know what I'm really referring to, but it was something new that we hadn't seen before and definitely pretty cool. When it came to the maps and everything in this game, it was overall just very dark compared to other Call of Duties that we see with very bright settings. And I think this was something that contributed to the fact that a lot of people didn't like this game. As you guys can see in this gameplay, I have the gold camo on this gun and it doesn't look like any type of gold that we see nowadays. Although I do think it looks pretty good, you can definitely argue the fact that it looks pretty bland compared to other Call of Duties and other gold camos that we've seen. But like I was just saying, this game is definitely darker compared to other Call of Duties that have significantly brighter colors to them. But this was something that personally didn't bother me, and I really did enjoy the gameplay overall. With that being said though, this game definitely introduced some pretty cool things to it. And one of the cool things in multiplayer was the briefcase that would fall on the ground that gave you tasks to do. And essentially what happened when you picked it up was you got a task from the game, and if you completed it in that game, you would get a reward. And the way that you got the briefcase was killing someone that was in the middle of doing one of those tasks that had it and picked it up previously. So if you wanted it, you had to find the person who had it and you would have to kill them and then pick it up and figure out what your task was. There was a lot of different tasks that you were able to get. Some of them were definitely more difficult to do, but if you did complete them, you got a better reward. I remember when the game first came out, this was something that everyone was trying to do. They were trying to find the briefcase and complete the tasks because it was something that was definitely pretty cool that we hadn't seen before. Some of the rewards that you were able to get if you did complete these tasks were getting a care package or some sort of kill streak. Something else that definitely stands out about this game would have to be the kill streaks. They definitely had some pretty interesting ones and a lot of brand new ones that we had never seen before. In this game's campaign, we were introduced to Riley the dog, and that was actually a kill streak in multiplayer, which was definitely pretty cool. And once you called this kill streak in, the dog would just follow you around and kill anyone around you if he was able to. It was definitely a pretty annoying kill streak, but it was definitely pretty cool overall. In this game, they had support kill streaks and also assault kill streaks, which is something that we've seen in previous Call of Duties. And in both categories, they had completely different kill streaks overall. So there was a significant amount to pick from depending on what kind of player you were. And in this game, they had something called the chem strike, which was essentially the nuke of the game, which was a 25 kill streak. Something else to definitely highlight about this game would have to be all the guns that they had. They brought in a lot of different guns that we hadn't seen before in previous Call of Duties, and the way that they played in this game all felt really good. You guys will see in these gameplays here that I'm using some of the fan favorite guns of this game, and it was definitely a lot of fun to hop back on this game so many years later and use these guns because I forgot about half of them and I also forgot how they play. This was one of the first CODs where we were able to buy guns in the store, and I always remembered some of them being absolutely crazy to use. I remember one specific gun that you were able to buy was an AR and an SMG in one. I believe it was called the Ripper if I'm not mistaken, but essentially you would click a button and it would switch an attachment and make it an AR, and then you can switch it back to an SMG. And this was something that I definitely found very unique about the game, and they had other guns like this. Something else to definitely highlight about this game would have to be the campaign. They definitely took more of a futuristic approach with this game, which was definitely pretty cool, and the campaign overall was a lot of fun to play and had a crazy ending. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but if you guys played it, I'm sure you definitely remember what happened and how it went. Now, the third game mode in this game was something called Extinction, and this was their approach to zombies. Now, with this game mode, there was a lot of people that just really didn't play it or enjoy it whatsoever, including myself. It was nothing that can really compare to zombies, and the stuff that was in it just wasn't that interesting. With that being said though, I definitely did play it a little bit, and it wasn't anything like a normal zombies game mode. You weren't going for a high round or anything like that. You were just moving through stages trying to escape and exfil out of the area. You weren't killing zombies, you were killing alien creatures essentially. So in a lot of people's opinions, including myself, this wasn't really a game mode that got a lot of attention to it, and it wasn't that fun overall. If you were playing with a group of people, there was definitely some things that you can do to make it a little more fun, but overall it was a very bland game mode. But I'm very curious to hear what you guys have to say. If you guys did play Extinction, let me know down in the comments below if you enjoyed it or not. As I mentioned how you were able to buy guns in the store before, you were also able to buy playable characters that had very unique designs to them. You were also able to buy some really cool camos that definitely stood out, and I remember getting a few. This was the first game where microtransactions were starting to get big, and everything in this game wasn't very expensive like nowadays in the store, so you were able to buy a bunch of things and not have to pay so much money. Something else to note about this game is the fact that this is my original Xbox One Call of Duty Ghost disc that I threw into my Xbox Series X and had it download with no problems at all. So overall, it was definitely a nice experience to hop back on this game after so many years on next gen. It was also nice to know that there wasn't any load times at all, and the game loads up very quickly. With all that being said, if you guys did go on to enjoy today's video, definitely drop a like down below and subscribe to see some more Call of Duty content like this. I've posted a bunch of other different Call of Duties on the Xbox Series X, so I can definitely link that playlist down below if you guys are interested in checking it out. Also, let me know what other Call of Duties that you guys want to see. With all that, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.